Who likes tennis balls? Who likes tennis balls?
Today I'm with Ollie and Melissa. She's a certified professional dog trainer. I'm Nate from Design Squad, and there's something I've always wanted to try. You know those sticks that let you pick up a tennis ball and throw it for your dog extra far? I want to make one of those, but for a flying disc. Yeah, nice steady throw. So here's what I'm seeing that I need to keep in mind when I make my device. I've got to give it that forward speed and as much spin as possible. In fact, I bet there might be some kind of ratio of spin to forward speed that I might have to try to figure out.
We're in the wood shop in the Artisan's Asylum, one of the biggest makerspaces in the country. I got some ideas that I'm gonna try to prototype, see if I can make something work. I'm gonna try to use a high frame rate camera to get good slow motion video so I can figure out the right proportion of forward speed to spin. Jack's gonna operate the slow motion camera while I make the throw. 3, 2, 1. Oh, sweet, this worked awesome. So here it comes, here it comes. There it starts, see? Boom, half a rotation in 2 feet. That's exactly what I wanted to see. How do I reproduce this motion with some kind of flinger? Zoop. I'm just gonna start putting stuff together and see how it goes. As I fling this, I should be able to give it both forward motion and a spin, because it's gonna rotate on its way out. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. 3, 2, 1. I'm getting a lot of forward speed, but not enough spin. Instead of rotating and rolling along as it goes out, I think it might just be slipping and only rotating a little bit. I wonder if I can increase the friction on the piece of wood. I need it to grip tape, like from a skateboard. So I'm just gonna cut off a strip of this and put it on that slippery piece of wood, see if we can make it grip a little better. It still is a little bit slippery, but I think it's better. There's definitely more friction. Hopefully it's enough.
So now we're gonna go outside so I can get a nice big throw.
I gotta practice this. I watched the video and it looks like it's releasing kind of early. I'm gonna try to change my technique so that I get more forward first. Maybe I can aim better. Let's do it.
That went a little bit better. I think I'm ready to try it with Ollie.
It's Melissa and Ollie!
What do you call this thing?
The fling it. So I've got this big long arm, kind of like that arm on your ball flinger. It's a little windy out, but hopefully it's stable enough to make a good flight.
Nice, I can't wait to see it.
Me too. Go, go, go! Oops. So the fling is working pretty okay. I definitely have a lot of that forward speed. Might want a little more spin though. In this wind, it's kind of unstable. It's also sort of inconsistent, so I gotta be very careful to make sure I'm releasing straight so the flying disc flies straight.
There you go.
Let me see what you can do.
All right,
you'll probably nail it.
Woo!
Melissa is an ace! The fling is working pretty well, but I'm still having trouble getting enough spin on every throw. I've got some ideas about how I might be able to improve it even more. Maybe if I add some more curvature, so it rotates more on its way out. The other would be to lengthen the guide itself to give the disc more consistency, so it flies out the same every time. This is so much fun. If you have an idea, try to build it. See if you can make it work. This is what engineering is all about. Ollie, come on. Woo!